Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Elephant Whisperer: My Life with a Herd in the African Wild book by Lawrence Anthony. Add to that a gift of telling his story in a way that makes you feel like you know these animals too. Who doesn't love elephants? The story of how Anthony connects with these animals is amazing. The author lived in Africa all of his life and developed a special connection with its wildlife. He lived on and managed a game preserve, facing many challenges from animals, nature, and man. Even so, it is worth reading if you are concerned about protecting animals from extinction. Such is the case of this book, and it's well worth the time to read. Some personal accounts are overwritten, trying to be dramatic, or trying to push an agenda. In the bio, it stated that the elephants came to the house after his death, and stayed for 2 days, seeming to mourn as they would for one of their own. It was inspiring to know just how well everyone got to know each elephant, and their particular ways. His account demonstrates that elephants can teach humans a thing or two about courage, compassion, patience, and tolerance. Not only is this author at the top of his field describing the beautiful African plains, but also one's emotions are piqued while learning from Lawrence's rare experiences with true wildlife. Very much looking forward to your next book, and your continued effort to maintain life and dignity amongst wildlife that need our help and survival. This is probably not for serious students of animal behavior, but then again, there are just some interesting points raised. There was nothing to dislike, except in the story of these majestic animals, and kind and smart author there always are the poachers. It is an interesting read, as if a series of short stories, each chapter beginning after a mild segue from the prior one. Anthony's intention was that the elephants, and all the animals on his reserve, remain wild, and have no interaction with human beings, other than himself. Along the way there are stories of other animals: rhinos, crocodiles, poodles, as well as African politics, Zulu society, poachers, and French women. Anthony knew how to keep your interest, and this book was a real page-turner. This book is a compilation of events that happened at the Royal Zulu Reserve in Africa. You really learn to love each of those elephants, and the main people in the book. Love this book. The daily elephant behavior was so interesting, and incredible, especially with the previously mistreated ones who took many months to adjust, and be happy again. Their whisperer owner was so patient, and gentle with them, it was a joy to read. This is a must-read for all those who love our planet, the animals, and need to hear that man can care for those entrusted to him. It was well written, and interesting, and full of information that the reader might not otherwise learn. They have learned great new vocabulary, great interest in Africa, and African wildlife, great respect for the tribes, and culture, and both have thoroughly enjoyed this true story. A touching, well-written book, with amazing storytelling that brings you right to Africa. Wonderful story about the bush, fighting to save animals' lives, dealing with poachers, Sangoma, etc. Two separate herds to spend a 2-day vigil with his family before retreating back to the bush. If you love nature, animals, and humans who make a difference, this book is for you. Very interesting book written by the man who rescued a herd of elephants and brought them to his reserve. Had lots of help building an enclosure, and lots of problems, but befriended these elephants and saved them and their offspring. He had a wife and had guests at the place who came to see the animals, and tried to rescue a baby elephant who was born deformed. It was a very interesting book about how one determined man was able to make a difference in the lives of animals. He also went away for 6 months to Iraq to rescue animals from a zoo there who were in danger during the Iraq invasion. Lawrence Anthony's journey introducing a small, but awkward herd of elephants to his reserve is fascinating. The story is of a familiar type: compassionate animal lover gets in over his head with pesky animals, but triumphs in the end, and learns great life lessons in process. But in this case the story is more than usually compelling. You are invited to share the wonder, but no particular explanation is forced upon you. He, and a very dedicated group of workers who literally risked their lives a number of times to save these elephants from being destroyed. The story is like a suspense novel in parts where you really do not know what is going to happen next. But they are disciplinarians, who don't take crap, and immediately correct bad behavior, so they can raise healthy, social, and responsible offspring. Told through the experience of a truly remarkable human in his life's work of saving and allowing wildlife to be. True story of the Tula Tula Wildlife Reserve in South Africa, and the rescue of a herd of elephants. It's heartwarming to know there are people like Lawrence Anthony doing whatever they can to save wild creatures from poachers. Anthony, when some of the animals died either of natural causes or shot out of necessity. The descriptions of the bush and the animals bring to life the way it really is. A remarkable story about a herd of wild, traumatized elephants and the man who won their matriarch's trust and saved their lives. If you like good storytelling, wildlife, and Africa, do not pass over this book. This book introduces them to the reader as they are in the wild, and the difficulties caused by ivory poachers. Beautiful story true about a life on a South African wildlife preserve, full of fascinating vignettes, and details about not just elephants, but all the creatures the writer crossed paths with, including the humans that worked with him. The elephants were amazing, and how this man took care of them, and learned from them. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe, and leave your comments below.